Hello, friends. Welcome to a brand new episode. Today's episode is a sequel to episode 201, where I am talking about why you shouldn't freak out about the number on the scale. Now, I know the scales are a source of contention for many. And in that episode, I am talking about the mindset practices that we can start to build up and you can start to build up to help you overcome the thoughts that we have. Because sometimes thoughts are not feelings and thoughts are not reality. And this is painting a mindset focus that we want to work towards instead of feeling like a victim in our circumstances. Now, today may fall into another mindset episode. If you haven't listened to it, go back and listen to 201. But for now, let's have a listen for today's episode. Why are the scales always different? Hello, Lose Weight with Macros, the Basics Podcast family. I'm your host, Verona. And if you're new here, welcome to the show. I'm a nutrition coach who believes in the power of real life tools to create healthy habits. I help busy women like you get rid of the stress and emotional eating that keeps you from creating resilient, lifelong habits that, quite frankly, you can trust. Instead of giving you another boring diet or workout plan or bland salad and tell you just to eat a whole heap of salad leaves while your family chow down on your favorite meals in the corner and you are regretfully eating that bowl of dry salad, I'ma help you learn how to use macros to lose fat, keep it off, and rebuild that confidence that diets often strip us of, that insecurity, that fear, that no longer feeling confident in our bodies that we know we need to get rid of. Friends, if this sounds like your cup of tea, grab your tea, your coffee, and your notepad and pen, because today's episode, friends, is gonna be a juicy one. So, my friends, if you're somebody who has this source of contention where you stand on the scale and you're expecting to see a different number. Now, I'm here to tell you that the scales are different because of the way that they're built, and that is a good thing. Each scale, it will give you a different result, but that's how it should be. It's not a scam, it's not a conspiracy, it's not the devil. Absolutely, it's not your friend. It's an innate object. And every one of us, either you or somebody else, has purchased this scale to stand on it and get a reading that's rough estimate to how much you weigh. And when we focus on this is what we're doing, this gives us context. This gives us key things to focus on. And sometimes we kind of put expectations on an innate object to make us feel better. It's almost like expectations in a relationship. If you're in a relationship with a man and your gripe is, why can't he listen like my girlfriends? I talk to my girlfriends for hours and they're very empathetic. But when I come home, he doesn't listen that way. I wish my husband would listen like that. Listen, men are not wired to talk the way that we talk, to listen the way that we do. They're not wired to do that. Stop trying to make your man into your friends. You've got your friends for your friends. You've got your man for your man. And let him be the man that he's supposed to be in the relationship. Of course, if he's not listening to anything you say, then you need to have that conversation. However, when you're constantly saying, I wish you were like so-and-so, what that actually does, it belittles him, it degrades him, and it also says that you're not content in something in your relationship. So then you try to look for something else or someone else to fill that need that you feel you're not getting from your man. And that kind of fills it temporarily, but then comes the guilt. It's the same when it comes to the scale. Now, it's obviously, they're two different things, but the point here is the expectation. You're looking for an expectation of something that cannot give you that because it wasn't designed to give you that. And that's the same thing with men. Yeah, some men might be chatty and want to know all about what you're doing in your day and all of that kind of stuff. But if we're trying to make our men into our girlfriends, he's never going to get to that place because there is a clear distinction. Men are designed to fix things. They want to come with logic. They don't come with all levels of emotion. So cute, like we do, but we're trying to do that. And we have to understand, what is it that I'm not getting? And if you're not getting that affirmation, give it to yourself. Stop putting unrealistic expectations on others. It's too much. And I'm talking to myself too. We're trying to put too much expectation on others to fill us, to fill a void that they were never designed to fill. And when it comes to the scale, we come with that same expectation that this particular thing, you're going to give me a number, you're going to help me to see a number, because then it will make me feel good about myself. And we're putting way too much expectation on an innate object. The object can't speak, the object has no life. But yet when we're disappointed, we get upset, we quote unquote throw our toys out of the pram. And then we find other women who feel the same way about the scale. But notice, they're not challenging you, nor are they encouraging you to actually get to the bottom of why the scale says that you've gained weight. That's why today's episode, we're going to talk about why are the scales always different. Now, there is a common one that women tend to say you're gaining muscle. If it's been 3 days, you're not gaining muscle. I'm sorry to tell you, honestly, it isn't muscle gain that you're having. It is water retention and fluctuation. Let's get into the habit where we're actually telling people the truth and it's something that will set them free. If you're feeling insecure about yourself and you're looking to the scales to affirm you, it's not going to work. Use it for what you or somebody else in your household bought it for to tell you about your weight. Is it going to be scary to actually finally see that you've weighed 250 pounds? Absolutely, but it needs to be done. Some of us need to see and have this reality check and this wake-up call to make the change that needs to be done. It's also important to understand and know that the scales aren't infallible. They can be off by a few pounds, so don't panic if they say you've gained a pound or two overnight. Be aware that it isn't fat that it's gained. So that's the first thing to know. The scales are not infallible. Okay, so they're not going to be mistake-free and not going to be 100% accurate. If you want the accuracy of actually telling you exactly what your body fat percentage is, you don't need a scale that you can stand on. You need a DEXA scan, which is an all-body scan that's going to give you a whole wake-up call about exactly how much fat you have in your body, how much post tissue you have in your body. It's not a pretty sight, but if you want to get real with your weight loss, some of these things you need to do. Some of us are too content and too comfortable in just living in this position, and we need change. The second thing is to know that your weight can fluctuate throughout the day based on what you eat and what you drink. For example, if you eat or drink something with a lot of sodium, a high sodium meal, fast food, takeaways, they tend to be very, very, very sodium high, or sugar. Your body will then retain water in an attempt to dilute those substances. And this can make it appear as if you've gained weight overnight. I could stop this episode right here and be like, this is it. This is the end of today's episode, and then do this in another part of an episode. But this reason why your weight can fluctuate throughout the day is based on what food that you're eating. And if you're saying, well, I'm standing on it in the morning, and then when I stood on it yesterday, then it's at a different number. But what food did you eat before you standing on it in the morning? That is something that you need to get and understand and get a grip of. And that is a mindset thing. That's not the scale that's the issue. The scale is doing what it's been created to do. When we have an expectation that we can try to alter or control what we want to see on the scale, and it's almost like we're then portioning blame to the scale, but we're not taking responsibility for our actions and our choices. That's the other part of fat loss that people don't talk about. Diets don't prepare you for this part of fat loss. Fat loss is accepting where you have contributed to it, not your fault, but accepting where you have made contribution and how you can change it. A diet that's causing you to restrict yourself from food isn't teaching you how to understand your body, how to understand the scales, how to understand this key fundamental thing is based on what you eat and drink. It's not the only thing, but that is something else that can happen. A third reason why the scales say you've gained weight overnight is because your body fat has increased. We tend to be scared of this one. Now, you can't gain fat overnight, but if you've seen this number over a period of time consistently for 3 weeks, then you can trust and say, right, my body fat has increased. If you're including strength training and then you've started to do that over an 8-week period, which is a consistent time to be able to focus on muscle hypertrophy, lifting heavy, no, you're not getting bulky, but you're eating your protein, you're increasing this. If you're beginning to start doing those things over a consistent period of time, and 8 weeks now on week 9, you're seeing that you have got an increase in mass, and you've started to see a decrease in inches, and you're also starting to see visible muscle gains, then you can absolutely say it's muscle gain. But we have to get to this thought where we are thinking this way. So many of us, and I was in that place too, you know, I used to think like, oh my gosh, it's the muscle. I've gained muscle in 3 days. We haven't. People are trying to help you to make you feel better because it's what you want to hear. But sometimes we don't need to hear what we want to hear. We need to hear what we don't want to hear. And half of these reasons, we forget. We don't know it. We're not told it. What it always is the niceties. It might actually be that you've gained fat. And if you have, change it. Because if you're already overweight, this could mean that you had a bit more fat on your body than you did before, and now you have even more of it. And we don't like that. Even though it doesn't look like much has changed in terms of how much actual muscle mass or fat mass you've compared with yesterday's measurements, sometimes it can get a little bit like, oh, I've gained fat. Think about what's come before that. Now, granted, not everybody does this because everybody is so quick to focus on the negative side. As your coach, when I'm working with you on a one-to-one, this is generalized, but as your coach working with you on a one-to-one, I'm then able to see, okay, where is this coming from? If you're tracking your food, if your sleep is consistent, and the other things that were an issue or a struggle for you when you filled out the application form to work with me, then we're focusing on a plan. And we're working together a long period of time to be able to see and understand exactly where those fluctuations are coming from. And then this is preparing you and equipping you to be able to deal with this. Now, we actually did this with a client who busy job, targets, all of that stuff. She came to me because she was struggling and we did high quality coaching. I don't do basic quality coaching anyway, but we did the mindset focused coaching. And one of the things that she began to start to get stuck on was the scale. So we had to break down things like metabolism. We had to break things down like what she's eating. We had to break down things like her stress. All of the biomarkers that don't get caught up in a TDEE calculator or in a diet that tells you to cut out carbs. All of the things that are missed that I do with customized coaching and other coaches who do customized approach. These are the things that we're focused on. So when we're focusing all on the things that can affect your fat loss, can affect your confidence, and we're building a picture over a consistent period of time, think weeks, months, and years, not days or even hours. When we're focusing on the latter end, that's when we're beginning to see, right, this is the pinpoint here. What do we do? How do we fix this? How do we focus on it? How are you struggling it? What are you doing? What does it look like? We're focusing on all of that. Now, when you're standing on the scales and you're seeing that it's gone up 5 or 6 pounds, you immediately think it's you. You immediately think you're the problem, you fat heifer. You start to call yourself all of these names. But if you can take away anything from this, take away the fact that the scales are not infallible. It's important to know your weight can fluctuate throughout the day based on what you eat and drink. And the third reason is a reason that we always don't want to actually hear. It might actually be that your body fat percentage has increased. It's not the end of the world. You still can address it. But it's important to understand these are why the scales are always different. And sometimes if you stepped on the scales only to find that you've gained weight overnight, it's a common misconception that the scales are broken. But instead of blaming quote unquote faulty equipment, it's about focusing on why this happened. Understanding how your body stores fat is going to be different to different women. And it's so many different things that people do not understand. We don't know. Your body is going to be different to Sally's. It's definitely not muscle if it's 3 days or 7 days. And we need to learn to understand our bodies. Stop taking these things that we want to hear from people who are trying to tell us nicety things. We've got to get deep into the things that we want to know. Let's get a little bit more deeper here because we still got some time. Number four, you haven't gone for a doo-doo. Whether it's a slip and slide in or your doo-doo in bricks, you haven't gone for a doo-doo. That you store feces in your gut can weigh up to an extra pound in your gut. Okay, so that stood there for every 3 days. That's going to weigh into the equation of the scales. We talked about sodium. We've talked about having high carbohydrates from the night before, because you might be like, oh, what if I'm doing this? It also could be you are dehydrated. It also could be that you are stressed. It also could be that the fact that you are exercising. All of these things are the body's way of compensating and reacting. There's all sorts of things that go on in our bodies that the scales do not tell you. If you have consistently started to have cheat days that spill over into the week and you're tracking your macros 1 week and then one day you kind of go off because you have an unplanned meeting with a friend or a family and there's food involved, you can't possibly track how much or what quantities or qualities of food were involved. You try to eat healthy, but more food comes out and you're like, can I have some of that? It happens. And then you're like, oh my gosh, I just want to throw it all down the pan. Then the next day that you stand on the scale and you're like, oh my gosh, it's gone up. If you've had a high sodium meal the day before, that's going to reflect, because sodium is a part of our body that we need. But if you're constantly having too much, that's going to show up as water retention. Now, I understand that this is a whirlwind, today's episode. I really want you to get this, because this is a contention that so many women say, I just need to throw away the scale. It's not your friend. What does that mean? The scales are never going to be your friend. It's an innate object. If you're trying to find friendship in a scale, there's something that needs to be worked out there. There's something not right here, because that's an unhealthy attachment. And that's what needs to be addressed, because you can't be looking for friendship in a scale. You just can't. Like, I was looking for friendship in food. That was unhealthy. I'm creating a personable relationship with a substance that should never be personable. It's just not how it goes. You cannot be friends with the scale. It's never the same. It's not how it is. You didn't buy the scales and was like, I need some friends. I got a friend in me. You didn't do that. You bought it to see how much you weigh. And that's what you've got to do. Weigh and see how much you weigh. If you don't like what it is, address why you feel that weight that's being gained. And if it is actual weight that's being gained, then you've got to address those habits. If you really want change, you've got to have a look at the things that we stay content and comfortable in. It makes us uncomfortable seeing our bodies, but we don't want to do the work that needs to be done to make the changes. When we are in this level, we've got to get this way. And I know this can sound a little bit harsh for those who are a little bit like, oh my gosh, you know, I'm a little bit softly. I'm not going to be like those women who keep you stuck in this playground. You haven't got time to play. 2023 is not a year to play about with your health or your weight. If you want to lose weight and you want to lose weight with me as your coach, I'm going to support you through this journey. However, there are going to be some harsh truths like this that we need to get rid of, because the weight industry and the fitness industry is rife with rubbish. It's rife with nonsense. And meanwhile, it will have you believe in that. And so what you end up doing is, just before you go to the gym, you're scoffing on a box of 6 donuts, and then you're like, oh my gosh, I earned this. Or even when you leave the gym, you've done it, you've got your donuts, you've bought them before you go to the gym, and then you're sitting hiding so nobody that can see you in the gym, and you're scoffing down on those donuts because you're like, I deserve this. Because you've had a higher succession of carbohydrates, then you start to feel like, oh my gosh, I'm a mistake, I'm a failure, let me cut out carbs. Meanwhile, you cut out carbs, but you're still gaining weight. You see, the issue isn't carbs, and just exactly, it's not the scale. And so many women have this belief and this understanding. I used to have this belief too. So I'm not just saying like it's you. We have this belief where we're so caught up in this lie that it becomes a truth and we live in it. And all the while we feed that even more, but we're never actually addressing the real issues. So the real issue is the binge eating. The real issue is the restriction. The real issue is how you feel about yourself. The real issue is what you're saying to yourself about yourself. All of those things can change, but they can't change if you refuse to address them. And that, my friends, is the end of today's episode. If you're taking anything out of it, take those things, go back, listen to this, look at timestamps, skip to the parts that you want to skip to, but we have not got time. Your body is not a playground. We ain't got time to mess about with getting stuck in these nonsense things. And then we're wondering why we're not getting any results. It's what we're taking in and what we're believing to be true that actually is causing us damage to our bodies, to our mindset, to our confidence. Instead, let's address these things one at a time, and then we'll see breakthrough. And then that's where we begin to see breakthrough. And that, my friends, is why the scales are always different. There's lots of different things, and none of those things you hear, you're a fat heifer, you can't do this right. See, you're the problem. None of them whatsoever. They don't even come close. It's based off of the things that I said, and there's more that I haven't covered in today's episode. But we often get caught up in thinking we're the problem if the scale fluctuates. The scale is going to fluctuate. That's just how it is. Your floorboards could be mismeasured. Carpet, you could have come after the shower. You still might need to go toilet. There's loads of things. None of those things mean that it's you. We have to get out of this negative thinking. That's the problem. The thinking, where it comes from, how to resolve it. Okay? And if you're somebody who wants my help to help you do that, I would love to help you get through this like I got through it. I had to address the painful memories, the painful things that caused me to be insecure about myself. When I did, girl, I'm standing on that scale every single day. And I'm like, right, the average is this. This is what I know I weigh this particular week. And I work it out. Some people don't have the confidence to weigh daily. I'm not trying to force anyone to weigh on the scale daily. If you don't want to do that, don't do it. But if you do want to do it in a way that you're armed with the knowledge rather than going in with fear and anxiety. That's what I'm trying to help you achieve. If you want to work with me, I'd love to work with you. You can fill out the application over on the website via nutritioncoaching.co.uk, or you can join us and sign up to the waitlist and let us know. Or you can join the macros group coaching program via nutritioncoaching.co.uk/focus. You can join the waitlist to find out when the next round is in 2023 and years beyond. And that, my friends, is all we've got time for today. Don't forget to share this with a friend who needs to hear this message. Please share it with everybody. Share it on your socials, put it in your stories, tag me. Share it with people who need to understand this message. Listen to episode 201 and listen to whatever episode and order you want to listen to. But if this is you, you're struggling with the scales, these are the things that we need to focus on filling our minds with, an understanding the scales are not infallible and they're going to have different tolerances. The floorboards matter. What you've ate and what you drank all play a part in it. And that, my friends, is all we've got time for. I've said that 3 times, but that's all we have time for today, friends. I hope you have enjoyed this episode. Don't forget to leave a review over on iTunes. And also fill out the survey. If you want to hear more episodes like this, or you'd rather not, let me know. All feedback is feedback. And I can't wait to catch you, my friends, in the next one. Friends, we've come through to the end of today's episode. I hope you learned something valuable from today's episode and can put it right into practice now that the episode has ended. If you found value in this episode, do share it with somebody else who can also benefit from today's episode. My friends, don't forget to download your freebies over on the website via nutritioncoaching.co.uk and also be in with a chance of coming live on air with me to get yourself some free Coach Fridays by leaving your question over on the brand new podcast page. va.nutritioncoaching.co.uk/podcast is where you can leave me a question and I'll answer it over here on one of the episodes. And that's all we got time for, friends. I can't wait to catch you in the next episode. Friends, we've come through to the end of today's episode. I hope you learned something valuable from today's episode and can put it right into practice now that the episode has ended. If you found value in this episode, do share it with somebody else who can also benefit from today's episode. My friends, don't forget to download your freebies over on the website via nutritioncoaching.co.uk and also be in with a chance of coming live on air with me to get yourself some free Coach Fridays by leaving your question over on the brand new podcast page. va.nutritioncoaching.co.uk/podcast is where you can leave me a question and I'll answer it over here on one of the episodes. And that's all we got time for, friends. I can't wait to catch you in the next episode.